The other one it gave me was highlighting my little Lego person as the as the extra person in the video. Oh my god, that is so funny. What does she have to say? I mean, she has a microphone, so I guess she can. I have a really cool battle for you here today. We are battling the AI snippet tools, Opus Clip and Vidyo. And I'm also going to throw in a secret extra one that I'm going to reveal at the end as well, just to give you a decent comparison. I am rating these things old school, giving them a rating from A to F. I'm here to support you guys, the DIY podcasters. I'm trying to save you time and money and energy by reviewing the tools that I know podcasters want and give you the hot take on what's worth it and what's really just like a bummer. All right, so here we are in Vidyo. Here we are in Vidyo.ai. That was hard to say. We're now at the point where the robots have got the video that I've uploaded and it's given me this thing here. So just noting I'm in the free plan because these are trials, okay? So what it's given me is three options for different snippets that it thinks would be good for me to run with. It's giving me a score, as in like how good the snippet is based on what it thinks would be good for social media. And then it's giving me the option to make a few changes to it. But I think we need to have a conversation about why it's a good idea to support your podcast.
I'm not even on the screen. I mean, my Lego person looks amazing, but I'm nowhere to be seen.
First of all, I need to actually be on the screen, so that would be helpful. There I am. The font is all wrong, so let's go to the subtitles. I've already uploaded my custom font because that font is wrong. The color is wrong. I need it to be my branded colors. And I think it's too small. Obviously, where it started the snippet is no good because there's a massive butt that comes up on the screen in the actual video that I've already edited, like the proper one. What is this? We can do a progress bar. Yeah, they're a little bit of a thing of the past. Let's chuck one in. Okay, let's see what that looks like. I can put music in, which is good. I like that you can put music in. I've already got music in the video though, so that doesn't make any sense. Text. No, I don't want this. 10 reasons to support podcasters. Can I get rid of it? How do I get rid of that? I don't want that. Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. Let's try that one because that's better. Can I move this? I can.
Some tips in here around how you can look at crowdsourcing your podcast and actually ask your audience in a non-sleazy way to help support your show.
No. Why is it over there? Okay, so maybe that was my fault. All right. Go to font settings, make it smaller. Thank you. And you can add auto emojis. Oh God, I'm always worried about things adding auto emojis because what emojis are they going to go with? Okay, so let's play.
Forcing your podcast and actually ask your audience in a non-sleazy way to help support your show.
So far, this has taken me 8 minutes to do and I'm nowhere near happy with that. The only things that I kind of like, the text, I guess. So I'm going to remove the emojis because they are the worst thing that I've ever seen. All right, so let's just assume that that's done. So if you're a pro featured member, then you can save as a template. Once you've done those settings, you can save it as a template so that you don't have to adjust the font and stuff again there, which is good. So I'm going to download that video. If I was on the pro plan, I could do it in 1080p, but I'm going to go with 720 for now. Okay, and the last one is this one where it features my Lego person, as the extra speaker in this video. Oh my God, I can't wait to see this. What? Oh God. This would be fun if you had two people. I mean, it's found a person. It's found a person, which is good. Nice work, AI. But this isn't actually a person. And I just think it's hilarious. So I'm just going to run with that.
Opus Clip has given us 7 different clips, and then just like the other one, they have a score, they give you a score, and then they tell you why it's a good idea. So I'm just gonna have a look at this first one. I'm gonna go to edit. If you go over to design first up, then you can change how many words you want on each one. I like 3 lines per page. And then I'm gonna go the caption position. I can go auto, but I can't seem to change it to where I want it to sit. In here on the free version, I can't use my own font, which is a big no-no for me. I'll just pick something. No, that looks terrible. I mean, that I guess is probably the best. Okay, so now we've got our pink and our blue, which is good. The layout settings, we're gonna just have it be fill. Ugh, I hate auto emojis, but let's play with it and we'll see. Straight off the bat, I like that there's more options in here. There's more design options. It looks like it's a little bit cooler, but the fact that the font isn't right is a huge no-no for me. And then we've got here, and you can see where it's put the little emojis into, and I'm seeing this absolutely everywhere. People are using these AI tools, and they're using the emojis, and it's just starting to look completely the same as everyone else's. Even the fact that the text comes up the same way, the engagement I can see is probably gonna start to suffer just because things start to look the same because everyone's using the same software. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna save and compile, and then I'm going to download both of these videos. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back and have a look at how these both look. Then we're also gonna compare it with a snippet that we did here at Bamby Media, just so that you can see the difference as to the customization that we can actually do when you're putting more effort into it yourself, and you can be less templated. So let's now take a dive into what all of these look like. From Opus Clips, the first snippet. If you love a show and it supports your mission, it supports your values, maybe it's a show on sustainability and helping the planet, maybe it's a show on mental health and wellness, business transformations. Way off and terrible. I don't know why the audio lag is so bad. I didn't do anything weird there. I just exported it. It does this weird like shaking thing. I'm going to give that a D+ for that one. Now let's have a look at video. And if you're a podcast creator yourself, you're definitely going to get some tips in here around how you can look at crowdsourcing your podcast and actually ask your audience in a non-sleazy way to help support your show. It's still an audio lag. The framing's still a bit weird, but at least it doesn't shake like the Opus Clips one does. Opus Clips one kind of was doing this like effect where it's creating movement by slightly moving, but actually that's more off-putting. So this one here is better because it's my own font, and this is still the free version, which is good. And I could also change the location of where I have those subtitles go so that it's kind of in the spot where I would want it to be. It's still not hitting the mark, but I feel like that would take me less effort to get right than the Opus Clips one. I would give this, let's say, a C. I can also hear that the audio quality is nowhere near as good. Both of those, the audio quality has a lot more of that like compressed digital sound to it, and I wouldn't run with that personally. I think video wins just because you can use your own font and you can change the location of it, and although it doesn't look as nice, like the actual interface doesn't look as good, it's a bit more to my specifications, I suppose. And there was much less of an audio lag, although this one still did have an audio lag. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show the snippets that we created for the same episode, not using Opus Clip or Vidyo, and I'm going to show you what they look like. This is a huge one. We have to remember that there are millions of podcasts at this point, and only a select few of them are actually backed by large media companies, large networks that have a slate of shows that they pump money into using subscription models and using lots of ads and all those sorts of aspects. There are so many podcasts out there that are just purely independent creators falling in love with the art of creating a show and putting it out there to the world. And from you subscribing to a show, you're supporting that independent creator. And that really feels valuable to me, feeling like you're supporting an independent creator, someone that isn't tied to anything, that can do what they want, and you're supporting them in doing that, creating that craft. That's the good stuff. That was a snippet that we created in the back end of Descript. You can see that we can actually then change the GIFs and things that we use and make it actually work in the frame instead of it just being wherever it lands. In saying that, we go a step further depending on the client, depending on who's doing it here in the back end of Bamby Media and the team. We create snippets not in AI generated places. We create snippets using Adobe Premiere and using Adobe After Effects, because you can do so much more with your customization and the way captions come in and the kind of animations that you can use. It's just a lot more customizable and you can get a much more customized result, which then sets you apart from everyone else that's using these tools. The absolute wrap up of this, who wins? What is the deal? I'm going to say that Opus Clips loses for me today. Sorry, Opus Clips. You've got a fair way to go before I would recommend that DIYers use that as a service. The next one up would be Vidyo. I think that that's actually a decent tool for podcasters that are doing everything themselves. Yes, you only get 3 clips and it doesn't really let you choose what they are, but at least you can customize your fonts and your colors a bit more. It would be a good place to get started if you don't have any video editing skills at all and you don't use any other software and you're just pulling this from YouTube even. You could definitely use that as a tool as long as you don't have other things in your widescreen video that you don't want to have it in there, because we already have all that stuff baked into the final product. This kind of clip situation doesn't really work for us unless we did a complete strip of all our effects and our GIFs and our sound effects and our all the things, so that then there was a fresh one to go into these services and then they clip from there. But you see how that doesn't actually save me any time. In fact, that just creates more work for us. There is a place for these tools. It's better to have something out there than not promoting your show in some capacity. So give them a try and see how you feel about them. And also just time yourself and see how long it takes you to actually create a snippet that you think is actually valuable, and then track the engagement. And then maybe at some point engage a company like ours or someone that actually does customized clips for you and see what the engagement on those are. Is there a difference? So I hope that that was really helpful for you today. If you got value out of this episode, please hit the like button, the subscribe button. I'm going to continue to do this really honest deep dives into software for podcasters that everyone talks about. I'm going to test them out and I'm going to see whether these are actually things that I would recommend to people, especially the DIYers. And I'm going to tell you if you're wasting your time. Absolutely. I'm brutally honest and I hope that really serves you. So thanks for watching. My name is Brianna. I'm the head honcho of Bamby Media and I look forward to speaking to you again next time.